Tab? Tab, do you got anything on Michael Fox?
Thank you. Seth will be able to. Hello, Seth, how are you? Exeter City lineup with Harrity in goal, a back three of Alfie Pond, Jordan Dyer, and someone else across the midfield is Carl Taylor.
Tonight you join us for the Exeter City game between Exeter City under 23s and West Ham United under 23s in the Premier League Cup.
Hello, Derek, how are you?
Yes, not too bad, Jed, how are you?
Very well, thank you very much.
Yes, and you join us here at SJP.
Yep, cool.
If I leave my boot and you'll be perfect, won't you?
I don't know about perfect.
Oh, you'll be fine.
Yeah. Maybe. The chosen one.
Hello everybody and welcome to St James Park for some Premier League Cup action between Exeter City and under-23s and West Ham United under-23s. We are still in the group stage, but it's straight knockout now for the Grecians, as anything less than two wins from the final two games will see Dan Green's makeshift side exit the competition. With Wolves on the horizon, tonight it's the turn of the highest ranked side still in the tournament, and no harder challenge for the Devon club either. West Ham sit top of Premier League 2, having swept away Man City, Liverpool and Manchester United in recent weeks. A draw for the Hammers will be enough to progress as they sit second in Group F, 5 points clear of third place City. Tonight, Green's team is stacked with first team experience and the draw against Swansea City last Friday has given the Grecians the tiniest glimmer of hope in a competition they have done relatively well in the past. Alongside me tonight is club expert on the Exeter City Academy, Derek Baker. Good evening, Derek, how are you?
Yes, not too bad, Jed. Nice to be here. Thanks for having me.
How long have you been covering the City youngsters?
My first sort of days back in the watching the Exeter City Academy were I was watching Matt Grimes captain the under-18 side that had the likes of Matt Jay, Christy Pym, and a few others, not to mention a few that have gone on, but Grimesy's the big one, and since then I've seen a lot of talent come and go.
So how important is the Premier League Cup to Exeter City?
Well, academy football is completely different to when the guys sort of hit men's football, and you see that here, really. They try to embrace the experience and really try and use it to continue their development and really sort of push on towards getting that pro contract at the end of their scholarship.
And there's no tougher test than West Ham United. The Hammers will be full of confidence going into this one.
Yeah, you'd like to think so. They're top of the Premier League 2 table, but they did draw with Arsenal on Friday. So whether they'll bounce back with a strong performance, we'll just have to see tonight.
And this is the Exeter City team Dan Green has put his faith in this evening to stop that West Ham onslaught. Harry Lee, of course, is between the sticks. Alfie Pond, Jordan Dyer and Colin Daniel make up the back three. Jack Sparks and Ellis Johnson play wide of a midfield three consisting of Kyle Taylor, Jack Veal and Callum Rowe. Josh Coley joins Sonny Cops up top with Nigel Atangana returning to the bench after being injured in November. Mark Robson's high-flying Hammers line up with bright prospect Chris Heggie, who is in goal. Jaden Fevrier and Harrison Ashby play wide of Levi Lang and captain Adji Elise in the back four. Apaya Forson Pia Ekwa and Kamari Saiwa play through the middle. Mipo Odebeko plays up top with Thierry Neves and top scorer Armstrong Okoflex for company. Derek, you've seen the teams. Where do you think the game will be won or lost tonight?
Well, as we've alluded to already, West Ham have brought a really strong team with a powerful sort of attacking lineup, if you like. Exeter have got to keep that sort of dynamic front line quiet, if you like, say, but West Ham don't concede many, so whether the likes of Sonny Cox can really sort of expand the game and stretch that defence, we'll just have to see.
A big chance for Ellis Johnson out on this right-hand side. How do you think, what does he bring to the team?
He's a really attacking fullback. He always sort of delivers his all on the pitch. When I watched him in the under-18s, he was definitely one of the good outlets that Exeter sort of had on the right-hand side. And I expect him to be up and down sort of on this right-hand flank as much as possible.
And City were good merit for their 2-2 draw on Friday with Swansea, with Callum Rowe scoring that lovely little trip. That's the quality that he can bring to the team as well.
Yeah, Callum Rowe, he captained the side as well, which was nice to see. And he really led by example on Friday. He'll be getting hold of his fellow teammates and making sure that they're going to deliver a strong performance right from the first whistle.
And for West Ham, they haven't just got Premier League experience in this team. They've also got Europa League experience as well. That's going to be so tough for these Exeter City youngsters to try and break down.
Yeah, I mean, on the average age of this West Ham team, they're older, I would say, than the majority of this Exeter City side. And as you said, some of them have sort of played in the Europa League. That experience is going to be massive, and whether that will be a crucial point in the game, we'll just have to see.
And Armstrong Okoflex is the top scorer of the season with 12 goals. He was on the bench against Leeds. Does that think that West Ham are maybe prioritising this as well?
It's really hard to say, to be honest. You look at the likes of Kamari Saiwa, who's also in the side and scored against Exeter back in October. It makes you think that really there's a real sort of choice that West Ham could have gone with tonight. And this time around, they've gone with Okoflex and Saiwa.
And with Exeter City, they're bringing in a lot of experience, first team experience as well, the likes of Jack Sparks and Carl Taylor and obviously Colin Daniel. With Nigel Atangana on the bench, there's clearly an emphasis that they want to do well in this competition.
Yeah, I think there was a bit of a lottery in what Dan Green's lineup was going to be today. And to be honest, he's picked a really strong lineup on paper with the blend of experience and youth. As you've alluded to, the likes of Jack Sparks in there, along with Colin Daniel, Callum Rowe. There's a bit of first team experience that will help the younger lads sort of in this match and on this occasion.
So the standings of Group F at the moment see that Wolves are top with 10 points. They've absolutely flying. They're all but secured of their place in the second round. West Ham, of course, are second with 7 points, with 2 wins, a loss and a draw themselves. Exeter, of course, that draw on Swansea didn't help them too much, but it kept them with a glimmer of a chance. They're third, level on points with Swansea. So goal difference, a win tonight for Exeter City could mean that goal difference is crucial against Wolves on Valentine's Day.
I think Exeter have shown against all the sides so far, they've given themselves a chance in all the matches, and they really do have an attacking lineup here, and one that will really cause the West Ham backline problems, despite them conceding the least amount of goals in that Premier League Reserve League.
And the one thing that this competition does almost promise is goals. At the moment, City have been flying. They knocked two past Plymouth. They got 2 again against Wolves, 2 again against West Ham, 2 again against Swansea. You almost wonder if Exeter are just going to score 2 more tonight.
Well, yeah, they've scored 7 in the competition so far, along with West Ham. They're both the joint scorers in this group. You'd like to think there'd be goals tonight.
We just get ready to get underway here at St James Park. The chill is in the air, and there's a good 150, 200 fans here in the IP office stand looking to back the Exeter City future stars. We're almost ready to get underway with Captain Callum Rowe kicking from right to left in this first half. A beautiful chain strip with a blue and white, almost Argentinian style kit from West Ham. It's a very nice kit, isn't it, Derek?
Oh, yeah, that's very nice, but nothing beats the Exeter red and white.
As the two players reiterate their stance towards Black Lives Matter, some things are bigger than the game of football. We're all ready to get underway here at St James Park for a grudge match, a crucial match for Exeter City. Callum Rowe plays it all the way back to Jordan Dyer, and we're underway, and it could be early trouble here for City as Dyer just about sweeps up and gets it away. And the Grecians, well, they're the mistakes they don't want to make in the opening stages, do they, Derek?
Yeah, I think the most important thing is do the basics right, especially in the first 5-10 minutes here, stay in the game, give themselves a bit of a platform to build, and then sort of then look at scoring as Sonny Cox is in, or tries to get in, it's cleared.
His pace is a massive asset for Sonny Cox, but it's also the goals that he just brings to the side.
He's just all-round play. He was a bit slight, I'd say, last season, but he's really bulked up over the summer, and you can see that, you know, his appetite for goals is still there. You know, he causes problems to defences that are all ages, so hopefully he can be in amongst the goals tonight.
West Ham turn in midfield, and there's a tiny little trip there from Josh Coley on Fevrier. That was a show of pace from the West Ham man, who just win a free kick and just bide his time, just make sure that he sorts himself out. It's a lovely atmosphere here today. It's not too busy, it's not too crowded, but there's still a good atmosphere here.
The fans and supporters have really got behind the Grecians youth recently in recent seasons. You just have to look at the guys who have gone on to bigger and better things. They just want to see the next future sort of Exeter star.
West Ham in this 4-3-3 formation, looking to break down City's 5-3-2. Not able to keep the ball in on this occasion was Thierry Neves on this right-hand side.
Yeah, interesting to see Jack Sparks is taking an attacking sort of left midfield role as Colin Daniel retains his left-back at slot.
Jack Sparks came on Saturday into a 4-2-3-1 as Harry Lee just miscues that into the stand. So Matt Taylor wasn't afraid to change things up strategically on Saturday, but Dan Green has gone with a 3-5-2, which has been so positive for the first team as West Ham win the first corner of the evening.
I think you've just mentioned it there about not being afraid to change things. Dan Green did the same on Friday. He started with Jack Villa in a right wing-back slot, but that was changed during sort of an injury break, and then he took on a right attacking midfield role and then played a part in sort of the first goal. So, you know, the coaches are really on board with, you know, changing things if they need to.
Six in the middle for Jaden Fevrier to aim for in a blue and white shirt. It's deep. It's almost too deep. And Jack Sparks will just watch that clear. It's a dangerous looking touch, but he's just managed to wriggle himself away and win himself a free kick for City. Good work from Jack Sparks.
Yeah, as I say, doing the basics right, winning the team a free kick and getting the team further up the pitch. That's what you want to do during these early stages.
He was on loan at Torquay after his collarbone injury. Needed to get some match fitness, needed to get some game time. Scored a goal whilst he was there. Can he bring that to the side tonight? As Harry Lee launches it high, Sonny Cox tries to jump highest. Thierry Neves brings it down. It's out to Washby on this right-hand side. That's a decent-looking ball here for Odubeku, and Harry Lee is very quick off his line and is able to tackle that into play. Really quick from Harry Lee. Well, positive goalkeeping.
He had to make that, didn't he? And it's an actual cracking tackle from the goalkeeper.
Harry Lee himself is on loan, returning to Dorchester Town. Again, as a young keeper, you need game time. The most important position on the pitch, some might argue. Jack Sparks can't quite get it clear, and can West Ham get it into the box? It's a sliced clear by Jack Veal. It's even higher by Jordan Dyer. City can just about clear their lines. Dyer has to sweep up again, but it might fall here for Thierry Neves. And that was well read by Ellis Johnson to get across and loop it high. West Ham showing their intent early.
Yeah, I don't know if it's a nervy Exeter team, but they seem to be just losing their touches a little bit. They just need to get their foot on the ball, show a bit of composure, just play themselves into the game at the minute.
Look at the kicking qualities of Cam Dawson in the first team and compare that to Harry Lee. It's something that he just needs to work on his game on. He looked a little bit shaky against Swansea in midweek, and he's already put one into touch, make that two. It's just something that he just needs to work on, just calm things down, and that's the role of a goalkeeper when you're playing against a team who play with such intensity. Need to be able to make and do the simple things well.
You just mentioned about his loan spell, and as you say, he really needs game time, and that's what he's getting whilst out on loan. And, you know, playing in amongst men as well, that will only be a benefit for him as well.
Jordan Dyer quickly closed down, but he's able to launch that forward. Comes all the way through to the bright prospect of Christian Hege. He made his development debut for West Ham United against Exeter City in the Papa John's Trophy. That's a decent ball up the line, though. Here goes Fevrier. He's just been slide tackled by Ellis Johnson. That's the second time that Johnson's been able to get across, win the ball, and make sure that Exeter City are out of danger. Although he does look like he was holding his back after that challenge.
Ellis does love a tackle. He loves just giving full commitment, 100%. You're never going to get anything less than a 7 out of 10 from him.
Dan Green barking out orders just down in front of us on the touchline as Colin Daniel looks to intercept that. Well read by Jack Sparks again, who's done the favours and turned well. Sonny Cox is looking to peel in behind, but Sparks is happy to drive on. Daniel again for support. Here is the 33-year-old. It's a little bit lackadaisical by Alfie Pond, and West Ham can come forward here. Big chance to slice it across the box, but Josh Coley will just have a little bit of time at the far post to turn and play it inside to his captain, Callum Rowe.
That was a nice recovery from Alfie Pond. He just lost possession, but he got his back into a good position, made the block.
Nice football again by West Ham United. Out onto that left-hand side with Fevrier. Tries to get to the byline. Jordan Dyer just about does enough and rolls it back into the path of Harry Lee. Good defending again by City. Daniel looking early for Sonny Cox, who's just came shorter than Daniel was expecting. Tidy touch by Callum Rowe, and he was looking for a darting run by Josh Coley at the far post. But you can see the direct play that Exeter City are looking to play, and is that the best way to attack this West Ham side?
Well, they adopted a similar approach on Friday. Swansea had a lot of the ball in the first half, and then they tried to hit him on the break, and that's how they actually scored their first goal, albeit it came from a goalkeeper mistake. Sometimes they've got that threat with Sonny in behind, but sometimes they just need to get the ball under control, and with the likes of Callum Rowe in that middle, they can do that.
Searching ball yet again cut out by Jordan Dyer. Here's Coley in midfield. Callum Rowe scored that goal against Swansea City to bring the Grecians level. That's a loose again by Alfie Pond. Just needs to raise his head as Neves can come forward. Now across to Fevrier. This is Equa in midfield. The Premier League team playing as a Premier League team does, looking to pass the ball with much more emphasis. It's a gorgeous looking ball for Ashby on this right hand side. A nice ball in for Neves. West Ham looking dangerous. Neves turns it back out to Ashby. That's a deep ball, maybe a little bit too deep for Oko Flex at the far post. And it's out for a City throw, but West Ham, you can see the quality.
Yeah, you can tell that they're the side that possess the Premier League Academy and, you know, are doing really well in that Premier League 2 sort of competition. But, you know, if the Grecians can just play themselves into the game, they've got quality too. Let's not forget that this is a decent academy as well. So, you know, as long as they can get on the ball a little bit and play their own stuff, I'm sure we'll see some good glimpses of football here.
With the players that have come through with the Exeter City Academy, it's hard to think they're still only Category 3. With the new updates to the training ground, it's thought that they might be able to up their category status. It's something that will secure the long-term future of the club. Can Sparks play a ball through? Coley is darting again through the middle. Sparks has looked to found him, and the flag does go up, and I think Coley knew that before it got to him.
Yeah, that's all right, though. That like they've got on the ball, they've got into an advanced area, albeit that the run was just a little bit too eager, if you like, and Sparks, he's just tried to find the ball in behind. But, you know, they've got into better areas there.
Jack Sparks has just gone howling down there after the challenge. He is getting up, and getting up swiftly, and that's a relief for Exeter City. The man who is somewhat injury prone, he done his collarbone in against Lake Norient. Carl Taylor has another run by Coley, unseen by the City midfielders. Taylor has looked to dink it over the top.
That's a nice
Coley
ball.
Does release this one. Can Daniel deliver a cross? Taylor comes short. And that was calm. Like you say, it was tidy football from City.
Yeah, as soon as they can get on the ball and just show their sort of game plan and what they can do, they're really taking it to West Ham.
Sparks with some space in the box there that West Ham are going to have to constrict for the rest of the game. Colin Daniel, he's only got two to aim for in the middle. He does a lovely ball into that corridor of uncertainty. Well watched by Heggie, because any touch and that could have gone anywhere.
Yeah, Colin Daniel provided a few nice crosses on Friday against Swansea. He's a really good outlet for City down that left-hand side, and he can put some teasing balls in as he did there.
Just see the breath coming off the players. It's a very chilly night here in Devon. A few players wearing gloves, almost all of them wearing long sleeves. Searching ball again for Thierry Neves. He's just got the pace over Colin Daniel, and he's beaten Harry Lee to the ball, and he's picked up the second one. Big chance here for Thierry Neves, and well, he almost took it too early. He done well to beat Lee to the ball, a bit hesitant from the City keeper, and a let-off for the Grecians.
Yeah, that was a bit, as you say, a bit of a let-off. Colin Daniel sort of let him go there, and he snuck in behind, beat Harry Lee to the ball, which is a bit worrying. That pace that he possesses is obviously a threat, and fortunately for City, he curled it wide.
Thierry Neves, who scored against Arsenal, Man United and Liverpool this season, clearly possesses a massive goal threat to Exeter. You wouldn't want to give him a second chance. Alfie Pond was favourite to win that, doesn't. Just needs to pick himself up as Colin Daniel will take a touch and look down the line. Again, Sparks had his head down and made the run, and the Grecians haven't found him. Rowe, can he turn in midfield? Such a high press from West Ham, it's difficult for City to play the ball on the deck.
Yeah, I think the most important thing, though, is that they keep possession. They can't afford to give the ball away cheaply, like they did in the first 5 minutes, really. But as long as they sort of lose the ball further up the field, they can at least regroup.
Trip to Walsall will be in City's mind on Saturday. Maybe it's a chance for Jack Sparks and Carl Taylor to get some minutes in before then, just to see if they can get themselves back into the first team setup. Good performance here tonight, and it might get Matt Taylor thinking. Similarly to West Ham, they've got a couple of players in the squad that are now involved in the first team, and they're looking through for one of them, who is Odubeku.
I think they're just giving Sonny Cox a bit too much to do. He's against two centre-halves here, and the balls into him aren't precise enough for him to get control of and really bring his teammates into play.
Looks like City have switched early to a back four. Like you say, with Jack Sparks playing a lot higher up and Sonny Cox as a lone striker. Sonny Cox, is he a player that needs another big striker around him to feed off?
Well, last season in the under-18 sort of setup, he was the one, sort of the main man, if you like, in attack. So I think it doesn't really matter if he's on his own or has someone to sort of play off him. As long as they sort of feed him in the right areas, then he can do the damage. Of course, this season he's really stepped up into the men's game much more, and I think just that. He's in that transitional period, if you like, trying to adapt to playing sort of bigger and stronger opponents, and, you know, he'll get there.
Loose from West Ham, and something that might annoy their manager. Mark Robson, of course, has ties to Exeter, doesn't he, Derek?
Yeah, he's a former sort of trainee at the Exeter City sort of, well, academy, but as it was back then. He scored in his debut back in 1986 and then moved to Tottenham.
Coley dispossessed in midfield and West Ham have three forward. This is Neves on the right-hand side. He's got Odubeku in support, Ashby outside him. Oh, it's a great effort from Thierry Neves. He couldn't hit that better if he tried. Really unlucky.
He's already posed a threat, looked dangerous on this right-hand side, and he's managed to find himself a bit of room, created a bit of space to have a go. He's beaten Harry Lee all ends up there, and he's unlucky to only hit the bar.
Bar still rattling. It was an extreme effort from Thierry Neves. You would have thought he'd play it outside into Harrison Ashby. Had the confidence to go alone and almost upset the scoreboard.
I mean, considering he's facing one of the more senior sort of City players opposite him in Colin Daniel, he's really sort of taken this game by the scruff of the neck and probably looking the standout player on the pitch at the minute.
Approaching the 20-minute mark here at St James Park. That Thierry Neves effort, the closest we've come so far. City yet to really threaten the West Ham goal, but they mean a couple of opportunities for good balls across the box. Just need the end product. Callum Rowe calmly tries to play it wide, but Ellis Johnson's out of position. And here's Oko Flex. Decent ball looking in for Camarai Swire, but City can just about get it away. Sparks with a neat little turn. Alfie Pond into the middle for Rowe. That's a dangerous looking pass, and Rowe will draw the foul. And just draw a breather for Exeter.
Yeah, they've got their backs to the wall a little bit at the minute. Definitely second best. But let's not forget that they managed to score two in the reverse tie back in October. So it's not as if they don't pose a goal threat here and they can sort of trouble that West Ham back line, although we haven't seen it just yet.
It's another loose ball for Alfie Pond. He just needs to tidy that up. That's the third time now. Again, City just being dispossessed in midfield. Jack Veal has to stretch to get that as well. Big chance here for Fevrier to drive into the City half. Oko Flex taking on Johnson, getting to the byline. Johnson slides in, may have got a touch on him. Still a chance here for Odubeku. And it's out for a corner for West Ham, but it was a dangerous challenge from Johnson to make there.
Yeah, as I said before, he does love a tackle and he loves trying to sort of win that ball. I don't know if he managed to touch that ball or not, but he's managed to scramble back, at least get his sort of body between the ball and the goal, and, you know, Exeter have managed to scramble it away for a corner at least.
Six in blue in the middle, another couple lurking on the edge. It's going to be in swinging by Ashby. It's a little bit low. It's well dealt with by Ellis Johnson at the near post. It's a chance for Exeter to break. A chance for Exeter to at least get out, get their shape, push forward.
Yeah, interesting. City brought everyone back for that corner. You know, they really don't want to sort of go behind here. You can tell that they're doing everything to stop West Ham scoring here.
Something Matt Taylor was saying on a podcast a couple of days ago is that he likes this young side, but from a corner against teams with more physical assets, he brings the players back just to ensure things up in midfield. Kyle Taylor, not a judge to have fouled Thierry Neves there, and City can get the ball down with Sparks. Neat little juggling skills. That's excellent work from Jack Sparks. Thinks he's drawn the foul, but not so by referee Elliot Swallow. West Ham forward again. Here's Odubeku. Neves is the only man in the middle. Little back heel now for Oko Flex. This is dangerous from West Ham. They've teased already. And Odubeku, can he get the shot away? It's just held up. Here's Forson. Worked wide. City are back in numbers. Ashby's cross is blocked. And that was good defending from Exeter City. They got back and they stopped the chance being created.
I think as much as the Grecians were showing a bit of a scramble defence, they did manage to get the bodies back and sort of just halt West Ham 18 yards, 20 yards from goal, and, you know, they repelled that shot, if you like, and it'll be another corner for the Hammers.
Another in-swinging incoming. There is a man at the back post, whether it goes a little bit too deep, it's into the middle. It is a West Ham head that heads that over, and Harry Lee will see that safely wide. Darryl, what do you think Exeter need to do just to make sure that they're a little bit more aggressive in the press?
To be honest, I think they're causing their own problems in terms of distribution out from defence. Midfield really need to get on the ball a bit more, just try and win a few sort of individual battles. If they manage to do that, get on the ball, Jack Sparks has shown moments and glimpses of quality, but the likes of Jack Veale haven't really got into the game yet. So just win the individual battles, try and get a hold of midfield, and they might stand a chance of creating more further forward.
Here is Veale on the ball. Chance for him to turn and play it back to Alfie Pond. That's high, and again, it's another good press from West Ham, forcing City into the mistakes, into the easy mistakes, really. There's really only one team in the game so far.
Unfortunately so, but, you know, whilst the game remains 0-0, you know, the result could still be on the cards for either team.
Positive for City is that West Ham aren't ahead. Like you say, whilst it's still 0-0, it's still competitive. Still a chance for City to cause an upset, if you like. West Ham, of course, top of Premier League 2. And that is the league that involves the reserve teams of Man City, Arsenal, Liverpool, Manchester United. The Hammers are leading the lot.
Yeah, let's not forget West Ham have a brilliant sort of productive academy themselves. You know, you look at the likes of Mark Noble, who's put in so many Premier League appearances, and they've had sort of...
This is neat by City. Colin Daniels broken into the box. What can he produce? It's into Sonny Cox, and that's just over the bar, but that's the best chance that City have created so far.
That's much better. The high press really caused West Ham problems there. Colin Daniels managed to get himself to the penalty box and produced a nice pullback, and Sonny Cox is unlucky. He's just had to have a bit of a snapshot. It just went over.
So Exeter look most dangerous on the wings. This time it was Colin Daniel that broke. Jack Sparks unfortunate not to get a foot on the ball there. Alfie Pond will sweep up nice and calm, but we almost went ahead that here up in the gantry.
But at least he put the ball out. He didn't play themselves into trouble there. You know, just at least it gets them back into shape.
West Ham are the self-proclaimed academy of football. If you date back all the way back to 1966, they're still proud. They still are a club that think that they won the World Cup individually. You can see why not.
Yeah, who knows, we might be seeing a World Cup winner on the pitch in years to come. You don't know. But that's the type of academy they have. They do produce some absolute top quality footballers, and I'm sure that, you know, some of these will have even more chances at first team level very soon.
Well, they almost had a European Cup winner in the summer with Declan Rice.
Just cool. Look at his development. He's turned into a world-class player now, and I'm sure he'll, you know, earn a move to arguably the top four, the top six very soon. You know, he's an established England national now and performing wonders for West Ham this season.
Sonny Cox brings it down. Can he turn away from four West Ham players? He'd do even better and win himself a free kick. And this is a real opportunity for City to put the ball in the box and challenge the West Ham back line.
Yeah, the ball came into Sonny Cox and it actually came to him. So he's managed to bring the ball under control and get his body in between the ball and the defender. He buys his team a free kick, and there's a real chance here to get the bodies forward and really create problems for West Ham here.
Two regulars of the senior side are over this free kick in Jack Sparks and Kyle Taylor. Both of them have a wicked delivery. We all know about Sparks' crosses, Sparks' free kicks, usually on corner duty for the Grecians. But he's only got four to aim for in the middle. Might be better if it's a Kyle Taylor in-swing, but it is a Sparks ball in, and Heggie has watched it. Didn't really challenge the attackers' heads too much.
No, one thing that I've sort of noticed covering the academy for so long, they really pride themselves on set pieces.
Odebeke trying to break through, but Harry Lee again is quick off his line to pick the ball up, yeah, and just slow things down for City.
They've got to be careful with that counter-attack. We've seen the pace of the two West Ham wide men, so as long as they stay on board and give themselves time to get back, they'll nullify that attack.
Elise just hooks it forward. Captain will get another chance to send the ball into the City half. Alfie Pond with a delicate little head back to Harry Lee, and City can just get their shape again. The back four is almost a back two at the moment. Ellis Johnson might be feeling the heat of an under-23s game.
Yeah, this is a big occasion for not just Ellis Johnson, but a lot of the younger players. This is, you know, one of the biggest games that they've probably played in to date. So, you know, they really want to sort of give a good account of themselves.
As a young player developing, you want to play against the best, and that's what they're doing tonight. They've made a good account of themselves so far. Sonny Cox with the best chance for Exeter City. Just firing over. There are the chances that Dan Green's side need to take if they're going to have any chance of qualifying from the Premier League Cup group stage.
In a way, this game sort of mirrors what happened on Friday against Swansea. Swansea had a lot of the ball in the first half. Exeter was second best, but they played themselves into the contest and had a fantastic second half. Whether Dan Green, we are hoping they build that platform to really sort of mount an attack and a sort of positive period, we'll see.
This has been a good spell for City, who've just grown in confidence in the last 5 minutes. Looking to match West Ham toe-to-toe. Maybe the idea of the change of formation from Dan Green so early on. That was Ekwa turning in midfield, and he'll spread it wide to Fevrier, who's going to spread those long legs of his to drive into the City box. It was a loose ball in midfield, and Coley... In fact, it was Callum Rowe who tried to turn and find Josh Coley. A little bit frustrating.
He picked up a nice position there just to sort of stop play, cut the pass out, but was unfortunate with his distribution there, and could have done with sort of just getting a foothold Exeter there. But, you know, West Ham have the ball again. They'll be building, and the Grecians will be trying to hold a solid shape.
Ashby on the right-hand side. Into Neves. Flicked forward, and it's a big opportunity here. Harry Lee again, first to it. Kamari Swire was trying to beat him. And Ashby has just been bundled over by Alfie Pond. It was a silly challenge to make by the City number 42. And now West Ham have a chance to tease the goal.
Harrison Ashby scored against the Grecians in the reverse fixture back in October. So he'll be looking to get forward and perhaps sort of get another one. He looked dangerous there, and Harry Lee got caught out sort of in no man's land at one point, but you know, West Ham have got the free kick, and they'll be sending bodies forward to try and break the deadlock.
Pond rightfully in the book, but with Exeter City's high line and against the pace of West Ham United, you just feel that they're going to have to tighten that up as the game goes on. But their first priority is defending this free kick. Carl Taylor trying to disrupt the West Ham timing of the free kick. They've still got six in the middle to aim for. Compare that to the City free kick in a similar position just a couple of minutes prior, where City only had four.
Yeah, the Grecians haven't got anyone higher than the penalty spot, so West Ham can send more bodies forward.
There's a lot of space at Harry Lee's near post as well. If Fevrier wants to challenge that, it's him or Ashby. Chance here for West Ham. It will be Fevrier. It will be towards goal, and Harry Lee just about gets his feet down, just about reacts well enough, and Jack Sparks will send that into touch. Nervy moments for City.
I think he was unsighted because Jack Veal wasn't sure whether to get a touch or not on that. He didn't, and Harry Lee sort of had to react. He just managed to scramble it away, but, you know, they still have that clean sheet. They're still in the game, and that's all we can ask for at the minute.
It was a cross shot by Fevrier, really. I mean, it looked like he was going for goal, but he put it in an area. Compare that to Jack Sparks. He put it in an area where his attackers can also try and get on the end of it.
Yeah, sometimes it's just all about, as you say, putting it into a dangerous sort of position for anyone in the middle to react in and just get a foot on, really, and try and turn it towards goals. And that's what they did there, unlike sort of Sparksy just a few minutes ago.
Levi Lang just stepping out of defence to try and receive that throw-in. Keep the ball ticking for West Ham United. Ekwa. Neat back to Elisa. Equa, that's a little bit short. Jackville got a toe to it, but just needed a little bit more, and it may have just opened up the City midfield. And a decent ball through for Odebeku. Flag stays down. Lovely little feet. Odebeku saved by Lee. And Odebeku has flashed over the second chance. Huge opportunity for West Ham United. He just needed his composure and the Hammers would have been 1-0 up. Alas, it's still 0-0.
Yeah, I thought he did the hard part really well. Managed to create space with a nice little flick and turn. Made a save out of Harry Lee with a low effort. And then the follow-up, yeah, as you say, just needed to keep his composure. A bit of rush of blood to the head and he volleys it sort of over Harry Lee's crossbar, thankfully for the Grecian fans here.
It's a gorgeous little touch to set up that. A little step over, a little back heel. Almost felt he was so annoyed that he didn't finish the first chance that he just rushed the second. But West Ham will have another throw in that Neves has won down on this right-hand side. And you just feel that the Premier League two side are just getting on top again. And that's always dangerous for Exeter. Riding their luck at the moment. So much space here for Swire in midfield. Here's Fevrier. Can he release a shot? In fact, he'll find Okoflex. Little step over. Beats Johnson. Gets to the byline. Okoflex across. Harry Lee again with his legs has booted that away.
Yeah, that's one of Harry Lee's strengths, is his saving with his feet, really. And he's managed to do that once again. He's done it three or four times now. And, you know, he's come to his team's rescue once again.
City looking for a foul there, but the referee says no. West Ham come forward again through Ashby. Equa. Little foot on the ball and inside. Okoflex lets that run. Brilliant football this from West Ham United. But Colin Daniel will show all of his experience and let that run out for a goal kick. This is great football from the Hammers.
It is, but, you know, what's just as not impressive but important, especially in this game, is just staying in it. That, of course, West Ham were going to have dominant moments in the game, but for the younger guys, especially in the Exeter shirts, you know, it's all about sort of trying to stay in the contest, not let the contest go. And at the moment, they've kept their clean sheet and remain, you know, level with a very good West Ham team as it stands.
And that's the brilliance, that having a first team with such a young average age, you're able to bring in the players like Carl Taylor, like Jack Sparks, that are still eligible for this competition by age number, and then also have the players of Colin Daniel as well, who can just add that even more experience to the team.
Yeah, I think you said it off air. City could pretty much play their first team here with the average age of the group that Matt Taylor has, but they've Dan Green has chosen a strong lineup here, but at the moment they're just second best. But if they can hang on, play themselves back into the contest, have another positive spell, and maybe they can get a few shots on goal too.
City have lost their markers on a couple of opinions. Jack Veal does very well in midfield here to hold the ball off and lay back for Daniel. Cox, who has been increasingly isolated in this first half, has a little bit of support around him, and now can he play it through for Jack Sparks? He tries to cut inside. That's strong defending there by Keenan Opaya-Forson, and West Ham regain possession. There's a good chance for Cox to play Sparks out wide there.
I think that's when City look their best, is when they do press high. It's a thing that they try and do from throughout the age groups in the academy. And you can see that Dan Green's employed that tactic here tonight, and they're causing West Ham problems when they do it.
They're pressing higher again through Jack Veal. Can he just nick the ball off? Not on this occasion. It's back to Elisa. But Jack Veal still doing those little doggy runs, those little shuffles, showing his commitment to the cause. That's what City need to show a little bit more of as well across the pitch. But Ashby now on the right-hand side for West Ham. Odebeku making another run through. Here's Neves. Can he hold it off? Here's Swire. Into midfield to Forson. Little give and go with Okoflex. Carl Taylor just about brings it under control. Can send it back for Johnson, who'll lump it down the line. Good football from City to get the ball away. Josh Coley faced up by the defender, who is at Adji Elise. And it's out for a throw-in for City.
When sort of the Exeter youngsters, they show a bit of composure on the ball. They can sort of string a few dangerous passes together and really sort of get in behind the initial West Ham press. And they managed to do that there, albeit it was unlucky that it went out for a throw-in eventually. Oh, they're in trouble here, though.
Breaking forward is Keenan Opaya-Forson looking for support. Thierry Neves has provided it. He's already hit the bar once, and he's struck on target again, but this time Colin Daniel shows his whole outside of his leg just to get it away. Jack Sparks will launch it clear. Josh Coley has got around Sonny Cox on this occasion, and now it's a chance for City to come forward. Callum Rowe over the halfway line. Now Coley on this left-hand side. Rowe again, little look up, little turn. Back in for Daniel. It's a chance for City to play forward, but they're happy to be patient on this occasion. Retain possession and start again.
Once again, the sort of initial long ball into Sonny Cox was much more accurate rather than played down the channel. That allowed him to get the flick on and start the attack.
Great run by Jack Veal to find Josh Coley into the middle towards Sonny Cox. It's desperate defending this by West Ham. It's just about getting it away to Neves. Ashby, he'll probably launch it down the line, but Neves has overlapped him. And inside, and it's very calm from West Ham just to be able to get it under control. It's another decent opportunity for City to put the ball into the box, and they're getting more opportunities.
They are. I think the next bit of the puzzle really that they've got to solve it is then getting more touches in the penalty area. Now they're finding a bit of joy, especially in those wider areas. Now it's about trying to link those passes into Sonny Cox in between the goal sticks and giving him a chance to score.
Ball over the top towards Odebeku. That's been the port of call for a lot of the West Ham runs. In fact, that was Oko Flex who was trying to get on the end of it. City travel to Wolves under 23s on Valentine's Day. Not for a date. For the last game of the group, Sparks onto the left-hand side for Colin Daniel, overlapping. Decent ball across again, but not quite as accurate on this occasion. And Heggie, he's been comfortable back there as the young West Ham keeper.
Yeah, he hasn't really had to pull off any sort of decent saves or, you know, overstretch for any attempts at goal. He's just sort of mopped up there, acting like a sweeper, if you like.
Ferrier in an advanced position again. Jordan Dyer trying to stand him up. Forson. Tried to play it wide. The intent is there from West Ham, but at the moment the quality has not been enough to break down this Exeter City team.
That's it at the end of the day. Goals win the games. It's not possession stats, it's not shots on goal. It's all about that goals column, and at the end of the day, at the minute, it's 0-0.
City will feel good merit for this 0-0 draw so far. They've had a good chance in Sonny Cox to open the scoring themselves.
Yeah, I think it's all about just trying to make those moments happen more often, really. There'll be positives to take from this, but obviously Dan Green and the rest of his coaching staff will be hoping that they can sort of tighten it up defensively, because they've allowed West Ham in a bit too easy at times, but as they have done there, they've given the ball away.
Oko Flex dispossessing Kyle Taylor. He'll play it back to Fevrier, who's been up and down that channel all half. Force and turns. Nice little give and go. Fevrier. In fact, there's Oko Flex again on the left-hand side. He'll cut into his right. It's much stronger right foot. Looks for support. Here's Ekwa. Can he let fly? Patience again by the Hammers. Ashby. Ekwa. Just about bundled through again for Thierry Neves. They seem to be getting every second ball. Ashby back to Ekwa. Little dink over the top and easy for Harry Lee to pick up at the back.
For all of West Ham's possession there, it kind of their attack came to a bit of abrupt halt on that edge of the penalty area. The Grecian defence, they managed to get back, regroup and just didn't really give a lot of space to any West Ham forward there.
Only his mother calls him Harrison. A couple of minutes to the break now. City looking to just hold on, make sure that they're there.
Yeah, a bit of a key moment this. Just try and get into half time whilst it's still goalless, but they've got to still stay switched on.
Could they even go 1-0 up as Callum Rowe breaks free. Looks for Josh Coley on the right-hand side. Jack Veal goes over him. Josh Coley goes for goal. It's just bouncing about the West Ham box. They just about get it away to the away side. And Odubeku is faced up against Alfie Pond again. But Pond does so well to play that back into Jordan Dyer. And City looking a little bit calmer. Callum Rowe needs to tighten up those passes. Lovely turn. Wriggles away from one. Wriggles away from two. And a little foul on the first attempt means that Exeter City win a free kick.
Yeah, as you said, bit of bright play. Oh, another bit there from the free kick.
Josh Coley goes early, but just misjudges the spin on the ball. Acting like an England cricket batsman.
Don't know if that's a compliment. I think it's that final third that's just lacking in quality from the Grecians now. They've had spells of possession where they managed to get the team up the pitch, get players into advanced areas, but just can't string passes together.
Ashby finding a little bit of space inside, but a loose ball in midfield is cut out by his captain, Elise. And the referee, Elliot Swallow, thinks that that's a free kick to West Ham. No complaints from City. Oko Flex, Fevrier on the overlap. Here is the fullback. Three City shirts around him. Chance for West Ham to switch the ball here to Ashby. Brilliant little takedown. Jack Sparks just standing up, forcing him into the mistake. Callum Rowe nicks in behind. Now Veal is inside of him. Veal has just let that run fortuitously. Carl Taylor just beaten to the ball by Elise. That was a good chance for City to come forward again. Just another little mistake in midfield from both sides, but that's what this competition can bring. It can sort out the experience for these young players playing in stadiums, playing in front of fans. Here's Fevrier inside the box, gets onto his left foot, shimmies it wide, and that's another scare for City, but another one that they have ridden, and another one that goes wide, and another one that means it's still Exeter City 0, West Ham 0.
Yeah, that, again, that's come from a bit of loose play from the Grecians in midfield. I liked where Callum Rowe was, just picking off those passes and intercepting the ball, but then they give the ball away once they've got on the ball in midfield into the centre of the pitch. West Ham break forward, create some space for their fullback, and Fevrier just puts it past the post.
City will win the throw-in on this occasion. Another wide goal kick from Haraday. City will be the happier of the two teams if it stays like this going into half-time. Real chance for them to show what they can do in front of the watchful manager's eyes, Dan Green. Third in command on the Exeter City touchline. Flicked in field. Sonny Cox tries to wriggle away. Can't quite get there. Fevrier needs to try and catch it out of the floodlight. It looked like he just lost the ball in the air there. Josh Coley sneaks in. Ellis Johnson can play it back to Jordan Dyer. Sonny Cox has Elise for company. Callum Rowe wins the header in midfield. Carl Taylor gets a touch, but West Ham just draw Colin Daniel into peeling from position.
Just winning the second balls at the minute, West Ham. They're sort of battling 50-50 with the Grecians in the midfield areas, but they're first on the loose ball. They're first to react. And whether they can take advantage of those moments, we'll just have to see. But hopefully Exeter can keep it goalless up until the break.
City looking regimented at the back so far as Oko Flex comes deep to receive the ball. Elise again looking for options. They have been there all day for West Ham, and there might be a bit more space in midfield to play with. Oko Flex can't get away from Carl Taylor. Can City hit them with one more break? Josh Coley trying to put the afterburners on. Held up really well by the West Ham player. Gets through two of them. Wins a free kick. Excellent play by Josh Coley.
Yeah, and that's what positivity can bring. He wanted to go forward, Coley, there. And, you know, some good dribbling skills, some neat footwork. And he's managed to buy his team a free kick. That will get Exeter up the pitch, give themselves a chance to get some more bodies forward and maybe create a chance from it.
City It's these moments that Grecians want to build from. Time where they've got the ball. Their set pieces. Who can they find? There's not a lot of height on the pitch in red compared to the physical attributes of the West Ham men. In this case, Sparks wins the header. Just a solitary minute added on at the end of this half. City will be looking to see it out, but they'll be seeing it out with the ball. Jack Veal has probably come from an offside position there. Linesman doesn't think so. Little give and go with Taylor, but he plays it back to Ellis Johnson. A few groans around the IP office stand.
As you said, though, they're playing for half-time here, unless they can break forward here.
Johnson, brilliant work, finds Jack Veal on that right-hand side. Cox and Coley to aim for in the middle. It might still fall here for Sonny Cox. Might still fall here for Jack Sparks. Goes down. Penalty to Exeter City. It took a long time to think about it. Took a long, long time to think about it, but City have a glorious opportunity to go into half-time 1-0 up.
And there's that sort of positive nature once again. It's brought about a penalty kick this time. Some good play down the right-hand side. They've managed to get the ball into the area. Another precise ball into the box. Sonny Cox has battled for possession. And there it is. There's the foul. And they've got the chance, really, to give themselves the lead just before the interval.
There's still a few protests from the West Ham players. Potentially on just the length of time it took the referee to make that decision. Sparks clearly got there first. They were just wondering whether there was any simulation in that either.
I think the referee was looking at his linesman to see if he had a better view of it. They took a while, as he said, to make the decision. And they're still contemplating it.
Derek, I think they've overturned it.
Oh.
Unclear as to why they've overturned it. Jack Sparks is fuming. Well, if it's a dive, then Sparks has to get booked. But the yellow card isn't out.
I say, the ref was never confident in his decision there. He was the one who initially gave it. He pointed to the spot, but they've overturned it. Whether he's had communication from his linesman, I'm not sure.
Frustration. Boos around St. James Park. There's a big opportunity, and it's a big turning point in the game as well. City could have had a chance to have gone in the break 1-0 up. In fact, they were gifted that opportunity. I mean, there's no VAR here, so...
But that's what sort of, as I say, positive play can bring you. And that will give the Exeter players belief that they can get into dangerous areas and cause the West Ham backline problems.
Can they do this now through Jack Sparks, who was going to take the penalty? And the referee has just given it away. He's called for half-time just as City were attacking. And there is so much frustration from the Grecian players.
I think Jack Sparks has just thundered that away in frustration. He's had a pop shot after the whistle and he's surrounding the ref along with his teammates.
Well, there we have it, an entertaining half of football here at St. James Park. The Grecians holding West Ham, but a few referee incidents that we can look back on at half-time and see what it is. But alas, here at St. James Park, it's Exeter City 0, West Ham United 0.